inspire, empower, grab your girls and soar a little higher, unlock the fire in you, cause real women don't bitch, no, real women don't, 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 real women don't bitch.
Hey, 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 thank you for joining me on the Real Women Don't Bitch podcast. This is your proud host, August Crenshaw, aka Mrs. Raw, Real, and Relentless. I am the number one advanced mental conditioning specialist for entrepreneurs because building mental muscle is necessary in order to implement successful business strategies. This show has been created for the woman who is not excuse-driven and needs help building a profitable business. I will be interviewing women from various fields who are willing to break the silence on struggles that specifically affect female entrepreneurs. Welcome to a show where I and guest speakers from time to time share our methods that help us beast our business no matter what is going on in our lives. Whether you are an online or brick and mortar business owner, this show is for you. We will hit every angle, personal, professional, and spiritual. Why? Because on any given day, you get hit with shit from a scenario involving one, more, or perhaps all of the above. It all impacts you and your mindset towards your business. I have made it my personal mission to provide a space where we dive deep into the BS we face on a day-to-day basis. We are on a roll. Today is day 4 of the Affirmation Challenge. And I have one thing to say to you. If it's gonna be anybody, it's gonna be you. That's the mindset you have to have if you are going to get into this entrepreneurial thing. It's so, oh God, when we have this vision, right? We say to ourselves, I got this great thing that I'm supposed to do. You get excited. You're ready to go out there and show the world. And then when you get out there, it's kind of like when you purchase a vehicle. Have you ever bought, I mean, we can go back old school. You could have bought a red Pinto. And then when you go out there, everywhere you turn, you're going to see Pintos and you're going to see a red one. Come up today. I remember when we got my Jeep Cherokee. Every time I turn around, I see that same Jeep on the street. That's what happens once you decide to take this nesty plunge and do your entrepreneurial thing. It's like, oh my God, everybody's a coach. Everybody is into personal training. Everybody's cooking. Everybody's designing t-shirts or whatever it is. Everybody's a graphic designer. And then all of a sudden, standing out doesn't seem as real. And I tell all of my clients all the time, yes, there are plenty of people on the planet doing the same thing, but the differentiator is you. There are a certain set of people that we're all created to serve, and no one can serve them the way that we do. And that is a reality that you absolutely must face. Look, I say this even from the perspective of MLMs. I remember a long time ago, I was like, I want to join this MLM now, because if I do it, I'll be getting in on the front end of the company before everybody else knows about it, which means there's a greater opportunity that my business will explode. No, that doesn't necessarily mean that. Or what about the people who say, oh, no, I'm not going to do that business because everybody else has already done that. They've heard of that before. They use that makeup. The market is saturated. These are the kind of things that we say when it comes to being an entrepreneur, and you absolutely cannot. Now, don't get me wrong. There are certain things that, you know, you may want to do. And it's like, okay, that's outdated. And you do have to catch up with the time. Sometimes you really could have a passion where there isn't any profitability. But let's just be serious and be real. I'm talking to the individuals that you know you have a gift. You know that it's marketable. And you know that it's something that you can make money off of.
You have to have the mindset that if it's going to be anybody, it's going to be you that is going to do this, because there are a specific amount of people on the planet that you have been created to serve. But there could be blocks in your mind that won't allow you to freely see that. And here are a couple of things I want you to take into consideration. Maybe, just maybe, even though there are a lot of people out there doing the same thing as you, there's one little bitty twist that makes the way that you do it very innovative. And maybe in your particular area, no one's ever seen that before. I know that there are plenty of other coaches that exist out there that are raw and real and tell it like it is. However, I noticed that there is a void in my industry, and it seems to me that everybody has this idea of let's figure out how we can sell this concept of 6 steps and 6 strategies and 6 figures in 6 weeks or 6 months, and nobody's wanting to have those hard conversations and tell somebody, oh yeah, you can pay me to coach you, but you probably need my services for 6 months to a year before you put a dent in your success after doing an evaluation with someone. Who wants to have those real conversations? And when I saw that, I jumped on it because it aligns with my spirit. It's the way that I am. I'm known for being very raw and real and relentless about my goals and telling the truth and telling things the way that it is. Am I the only person in this world that exists like that? No. But in this bubble, in this arena, with the people that I've been created to serve and the individuals that have been designed to have an ear to hear my message, I look like a beacon of light. That is the same attitude you have to have about yourself when it comes to business. You may not have a golden idea that makes you stand out. Maybe what you have is stellar customer service. This is something that seems like it has died as well. When everybody's trying to figure out how they can be the Walmart of something, and unfortunately being the Walmart of something also means long lines, poor customer service, impatient individuals working, the probability being high that you purchase something defective. Maybe you're not going to necessarily be extremely expensive, but not only will you give a quality product, you will also give a quality experience. There's something that you bring to the table in a way that is so uniquely you. I've mentioned this on a podcast before. Think about this. I teach women how to walk in their confidence. I help them. I spark motivation. I give them advice and strategies about how to run their business. But one of the unique commonalities with the women that I work with is that most of them have felt like misfits. They've dealt with some level of abandonment from their closest relatives, like mother, father, grandmother, grandfather, and they've had a hard time shining and being them. They come from families who have strong ties to education, the medical field, and things of that nature, attorneys. They may not have been encouraged to be an entrepreneur because they were put down this educational path and it did not align with them. Here I come, this woman with half her head shaved off and with half her hair shaved off, and now my hair is purple, but yet and still I'm the epitome of professionalism. I'm the epitome of someone who cares and that is compassionate and is so pro serve your clients to the highest degree. They have great experiences, and subconsciously, every time they're around me and they see the freedom that I possess in expressing myself, I'm actually teaching by example that they should be comfortable being who they are. They should be comfortable being in their own skin. And there's something about the intimacies between us. It's literally just between us that holds those bonds and those ties together. So when I sing a song and it's really quirky in the way I do it, and it just so happens to be their favorite song too, when I do something that's really strange and all of us are laughing until our face hurts, there are commonalities and bonds that occur in your business specifically because it's happening with you and through you. Therefore, if it's going to be anybody, it's going to be you that's going to take action on moving forward with your dream. And that's what I need you to talk about. That's what I need you to journal about. And this is where the next piece of your affirmation is going to come from. Why is it going to be you? What have you noticed that's missing in your industry? What is that need or that void that you're filling? What is this grand idea that you have? And just speak that passion and understand that you're the only person in the room. You're the only person that matters. And then write that thing out. As you release all those things that stimulate you and get your mind going, then just surmise it all. So let's look at this. Day one, it was, I can, therefore I will. Day two, I'm built for this. Day three, I can show you better than I can tell you. And day four, if it's gonna be somebody, it's gonna be me. Just these statements alone are affirmations in themselves, but because you're building them together, I keep reiterating this, because you're building them all together and it's coming from the journaling experience of your heart and your soul, the words that you put together have more weight than gold. So let's listen to the affirmation that I created once I first created this challenge. Using all of those previous statements, just listen to it. Because it's building, right? For those of you that have been following along, if you haven't been, you need to go back. We're on day four. Did you hear day four? So get back to day one. But let me go ahead and read this. I can help people with their confidence and mindset. Therefore, I will be a personal development coach. I am built for this because people always tell me my advice / perspective gives them hope. To get things going, I'm going to get my contracts in order, set up a method for payment, and ask 3 people a week if they need my services. I've noticed in the industry there is a need for real, raw coaching where people are the focus, not money. If anyone is going to reach these people, it has to be me. I was created to help a specific group of people. Oh, wow. Are you guys catching all of this? That's exactly where you need to be. Build up those affirmations. Get your mojo up high. Like I said, I can't wait to hear what some of you guys have been coming up with. Share them with me as you go. I don't care when you hear this podcast. You could be a person that happens to stumble across this an entire year later after this has been produced. I still want you to reach out to me and email me and let me hear what your results are. We're building up, you guys, but we're not done yet. I'll be back tomorrow as we continue to progress, build that mojo up so that I can impact you entrepreneurs so that you can stand in your authority and walk in your purpose. Until the next segment, I'm out of here. Thank you for joining me today. Remember to cultivate a mindset that is biased towards taking action. No bitching, whining, or complaining. Here, our mantra is, real women don't bitch, we get shit done. See you next week as I continue to bring you what you need to keep your head in the game and beast your business. Don't forget to hit subscribe and leave us a 5-star review. Would you like a specific topic covered? Have a question you would like answered live? Then head on over to realwomendontbitchpodcast.com. Subscribe to my email list. Hit me up and I got you. Interested in being a guest speaker? You walk the walk? Then you can sign up on the website too. This is your number one advanced mental conditioning specialist for entrepreneurs, Mrs. Raw, Real, and Relentless. Signing out. Deuces! Inspire, empower, grab your girls and soar a little higher. Unlock the fire in you.